Hi, new challenge from Professor Walter Lewin about physical pendulum. First of all, what is physical pendulum? This is different between that one and classical pendulum. Classical pendulum, I put this here, this physical pendulum. Classical pendulum has whole mass here and massless string. But formal is 2 pi square root of L divided by G. G means 9.81 gravitation acceleration. This formula is slightly different because of distribution of mass. Today I'm lost pretty much in math, so I calculated a lot and lot of papers based on his explanation on the blackboard, 2 pi, 112, blah, 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 blah. But my way is actually calculation period of period of oscillation is 2 pi square root 2/3 times L divided by G. So the difference is 2/3 and instead 112, which are pretty lost. I did not get the proper result. How I found, I actually no answer, but I cannot explain how I found this 2/3. So I asked Wikipedia. And Wikipedia say that this is a similar problem, not the same exactly, but here is you can find inertia is 1/12 mass times length of the rod or the beam squared, and down is more mathematic, which I'm now pretty recording 10 times, I don't know how much. It follows that the CP is center of percussion or center of oscillation, is 2/3 of the length of the uniform beam L. Actually, this uniform beam, uniform mass distribution, with center of mass CM and CP, which Professor Walter Lewin say that I should to use only his letters, but it is the same. So 2 pi, let me bring this calculation. This beam is 0.407 meters or 407 millimeters. Weight is 107 grams, but this is not important at all. So this is calculated, so let me show how to calculate 2 pi times square root of 2/3 times L is 0.407 divided by G 9.806. So 1 second and the rest, but because I will 10 times measure, 10 swings, then divide the result by 10, so times 10, I should to get result 10 seconds 45, let's call it 45, or 449 milliseconds, but my reaction time is not great. So I installed this time stopwatch and already measured, but this time I will measure again. So I first will swing, then at this point, let's do it again, at this point I will start measure and stop measure. Just wait until stop here hitting. Now, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 10.47. Error in mathematics is actually not, error in my reaction time is probably 0.1 second. 100 milliseconds. So let's try to measure again. Reset timer and do it again. Now 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. A little bit better result. The more measurement, the better. Now, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, let's do it again. On this camera I will actually provide, so let me see whether I can, I'm about to avoid messing with this camera, so let's again. Now, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Huh, 10. This is within 0.1 second. My reaction time is not the best. So this is it actually. So, yes, I tried to calculate his way, but I just once got the result. By means of this formula, I got lost. I think that's it. I recorded 5 times. I now will collect all pieces and try to make one video. Sleepless night. Yes, thank you, Professor Walter Lewin. I want more. We want more. Bye bye. Wikipedia help. Sorry, messed. Let's record again. Gravitational acceleration 9.81 here. Actually, here is 9.06. Hi. New challenge from Professor Walter Lewin. Sorry for this mess. This is okay. Second time. Time. Hi. Pendulum problem.